And now, Taking Control with Dr. Josh.
Okay, it's the new year. Did you set a resolution? Another question, are you already rethinking it? Joining us today to keep us on track with our resolutions is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Clayfo. Okay, Dr. Josh, it was all about setting that resolution last week. Some of us kind of straying away already. How do we stay on track with that?
You're straying away already.
I didn't say me. I'm not calling names. But yes, some of us are straying away a little bit.
We are. And we're doing it because in our minds we think, okay, all I need to do is just have the dedication and motivation to stick with it forever. Mm-hmm. And that's impossible. And you cannot rely on motivation alone. So I'm here today to give you five actions that are going to allow you to not rely just on motivation, but to kind of give you a game plan for sticking with it.
That's great, fantastic, because a lot of us don't make it to February, so we're going to need these five tips.
You got it.
Help us out.
All right. It spells out an acronym or the word SMART. When we start with the letter S, mm-hmm. we actually talked a little bit about it last week, which is to set very specific and reachable goals. Mm-hmm. If you already think that your goals are not reachable, back off a little bit, change up the goals, make them reachable.
So I can't just say that I'm not going to eat potato chips at 5 a.m. in the morning anymore. I have to be more specific, saying that I'm going to walk a different path to the studio, not by the snack machine.
The more specific, more likely you are to do it.
Okay.
All right. Now, M stands for monitoring your successes. The more you track what you do, the more likely you are to do it. So writing down the foods that you eat, writing down the exercises that you do, keeping track of how much money you save, monitoring your success will help you stick with it. So that's the second one.
Okay, and is it a good idea to have someone to help you be accountable for that as well?
Absolutely. Wow. Although you jump to R, which is recruiting
for
success.
I'm sorry.
But you know what? We can go in any order you want.
Let's go to A.
Arrange for success.
Okay.
And that's what you were talking about, which is look at your world and do the small things that are going to increase the chances of being successful.
Okay.
So things like, if you want to get rid of and not eat junk food, keep it out of your house. You don't want to eat potato chips, don't have them in your house, and take a new route so you don't pass by that vending machine. Those
That's
small
it.
Things. And then you tapped on R, which is recruit support.
Gotcha.
Get people to help you. If they're not supporting you, ask them. Ask Teddy to support you when you are not wanting to eat potato chips, things like that.
And makes then the perfect sense.
Last one, which is my favorite, is be good to yourself, treat yourself. Treat yourself every week that you've stuck with your resolution. Don't hold out some goal at the end of the year is when I'm going to give myself a treat for sticking with it. Get yourself week to week by rewarding yourself at the end of the week.
Because,
those five things.
Yeah, that makes perfect sense. If I go hard 3 weeks without eating potato chips, I'm just saying by Friday of the third week, I'm going to get a party-sized bag and just go in hard.
I'd rather see you have a few potato chips each week than blow it with a binge at the end of 3 weeks.
That's great. Great advice, Dr. Johnson. It's so timely. I'm glad we didn't wait until weeks into the new year to say this because...
Never.
Some of us are not going to make it that far. All right, Dr. Josh here. And you can check this segment and many more Taking Controls on our website, cbs42.com. Ted.